Hi, it's me, Gabe Alcala, here from Advanced Test Equipment Rentals. Today we're going to be working with Montena's PG1275, which is used for Mil-STD 1275 testing for surge and spike on 28-volt DC circuits. Now let's look at the standard accessories that are going to come included with the rental of the generator. It's going to come with a user manual, 8 of these 400 amp connector bodies, which are used to connect your DC source to the generator, and also from the generator to your EDUT. They are rated at 400 amps since that's the max current capability of the generator. You're also going to receive this unlock key to actually disconnect the connector bodies from the generator once you're done with testing. It's going to come with an instruction guide to actually show you how to remove the connector bodies. It's going to come with a high voltage interconnect cable, a control interconnect cable, a safety interlock connector, a power cord, a USB and RS-232 cable in case you would like to write commands and use the generator in remote mode. Let's now configure the PG1275 for a spike test. To do that, we're going to reference this schematic, which is going to show us how we're going to connect the DC source to the generator and from the generator to your EDUT. Our first step is going to be connecting our high voltage interconnect cable. From here to here. Now I'm going to connect my control interconnect cable. From control 2 to control 2. Now I'm going to grab a black connector body and connect that to the 28 volt spike input, and I'm going to have this connected to the positive terminal of my DC battery or my DC power supply, which for our demonstration I'm eventually hooking up to a 28 volt DC power supply. Next, I'm going to grab a green connector body and connect it to the 0 volt input connector. So this is going to connect to the negative terminal of my DC power supply. Now I'm going to grab another green connector body and connect this to the 0 volt EDUT connector. So this is going to connect to the negative terminal of my EDUT. Now I'm going to grab a gray connector body and connect it to the 28 volt EDUT output connector. And this will connect to the positive terminal of my EDUT. Now the interlock connector. And finally the power cord. And then I'm going to flip the power switch. Now that our PG1275 has finished booting up, I'm going to be in the main menu. And I'm going to use the control knob and scroll down to the imported spike test and press it down. From here, I could change the output amplitude of the spike from negative 500 volts to positive 500 volts. And I'll leave it at 500 volts positive for this demonstration. I'm going to set my pulse repetition rate at 1 second, but I could set it as low as 0.2 seconds or up to 9.9 seconds. And I'm going to set my number of pulses at 10 pulses. Now I'm going to ensure my emergency stop knob is turned clockwise. Arm the device by pressing the high voltage button and press the red pulse button to begin discharging. As soon as the generator starts doing the spikes, you're going to hear the relays clicking, but if you would like to verify the waveforms, you would simply connect a differential probe between the EDUT output terminals on the generator. And as you can see here, our oscilloscope has captured the waveform. For our final demonstration, we're going to show you guys how to do a surge test using our PG1275. Now, in order to do this test, you're going to need a second DC battery or second DC power supply, and either reference this 40 volt diagram or this 100 volt surge diagram from the manual. We have already set up our connections on the rear of the generator. And when we're at the main menu, we're going to want to select the imported surge button. Then from here, we can change the pulse length between 20 milliseconds up to 80 milliseconds. We'll leave it at 20 milliseconds for the demonstration. The pulse period, we could change from half a second all the way up to 9.9 seconds. We'll leave at 1 second for this demonstration. And we'll leave the maximum pulses at 10 pulses. Once again, we're going to ensure the emergency stop switch is set all the way to the clockwise position. Then we're going to arm the generator by pressing the high voltage button and press the pulse button to actually discharge the surges. The verification for the surge is going to be a little different than the spike test, as you're going to have to connect a 50 ohm load across your leads of your differential probe. As you can see here, our oscilloscope is capturing the surge waveforms. For more information on the PG1275 or other EMC equipment, please call us or visit our website.